The previous video discussed the different photosensitive detectors used in analytical instruments. This video covers the optical elements used to isolate the wavelengths of radiation and obtain monochromatic light. These optical elements are called filters or monochromators. The first element is an optical filter. The optical filters are further classified as absorption filters and interference filters. The absorption filters absorb light of certain wavelengths and only allow radiation of a particular wavelength to pass through it. They are made of materials like colored glass, colored gelatin papers, or colored solutions. The light allowed to pass depends on the material color. For example, red will allow the radiations in the red region to pass, and so on. The selectivity in such filters is very low, and the emissions exiting these filters are not highly monochromatic. One can increase the selectivity of these filters by stacking them one after the another. However, this method can affect the intensity of radiation and reduce it. The next type of filter is the interference filter. For this, we need to understand the concept of interference. Consider two sine waves. If the crest of one wave matches with the crest of another wave, the addition of these two waves creates a wave having a maximum amplitude. This phenomenon is called constructive interference. Similarly, if crest of one wave aligns with the trough of another wave, the waves cancel out each other, and the final wave has zero intensity. This is called destructive interference. Using this phenomenon of interference, we can obtain light of the desired wavelength. The wavelength required undergoes constructive interference, while the radiations of other wavelengths are cancelled out by destructive interference. The filter using this property of interference is called as an interference filter. It is constructed using two semi-transparent layers of silver deposited on a transparent glass plate. A transparent dielectric film separates these layers. The space of film has a low refractive index, and the thickness of space of film determines the wavelength of the light that would be transmitted. The light transmitted by the first layer of silver reaches the second silver screen, where it gets transmitted, and some part gets reflected back towards the first layer. When the reflected wave strikes the first silver screen, it undergoes reflection, and the wave moves towards the second screen. On hitting the second silver layer, some part gets transmitted. If this transmitted wave and the earlier transmitted wave are in phase and their troughs match, a constructive interference takes place. Radiations of all the other wavelengths undergo destructive interference, and those waves get diminished. The formula connecting the wavelengths that undergo constructive interference is m lambda equals 2d sine theta. Here, the incident radiations are perpendicular to the surface, so sine 90 equals 1. D is the thickness of the spacer film, or distance between two silver layers. By adjusting this thickness, one can select the required wavelength. Suppose one needs to design a filter that allows the radiation of 400 nanometers to pass. If the order of interference M is considered 1, then the thickness D of the spacer film should be 200 nanometers. The isolation in interference filters is better compared to absorption filters. The next optical element that can be employed to isolate the desired wavelength is the prism monochromator. This device has a prism and a set of mirrors which focus and collimate light from input slit to prism and from the prism to output slit. The property of prism to disperse light according to its wavelength is used in prism monochromator. When light falls on the prism, it gets separated into its figure components. Different wavelengths of radiations get refracted at different angles when they change their travel medium. Looking at prism monochromator, we can understand its working. Light from the source enters the monochromator through the input slit. This light is focused on a collimating mirror, which renders the light beam parallel. This light is composed of different wavelengths. when the radiation falls on the prism surface, different wavelengths present in the radiation bend at different angles and get separated. These separated radiations then reflect and are focused on the output slit. Since the wavelengths are separated, they travel in different paths towards the slit and are focused at different locations. By moving the output slit, one can select the desired wavelength of light required by the application. The diffraction grating is also used to separate the wavelengths of light. The diffraction grating is constructed by etching closely spaced parallel grooves on a reflecting surface. When light falls on these grooved surface, it acts as a narrow mirror and light diffracts. The radiation overlaps the radiation from other grooves and interference occurs. Depending on the separation of grooves as seen by light, a certain wavelength of light can be in phase or out of phase. If the crest match, constructive interference occurs and the light of that particular wavelength is obtained at the output of grating. Similarly, if the crest of wave matches with its trough, destructive interference occurs and the light of that particular wavelength gets diminished. The wavelength that can be obtained is given by the mathematical expression m lambda equals 2d sin theta. For a fixed set of grooves with a separation distance of d, one can get the wavelength by rotating the grooved surface, that is, by changing the angle theta perceived by the light. That's it for the current video. Interested viewers can check the previous video on photosensitive detectors. Find the links in the description below. Subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to never miss an update from Practical Ninjas. Don't forget to check out our Facebook and Instagram page. Stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.